Hi everyone, this is Niki Rowland, and today I am making a layout for Bramble Fox using the December Fox Box, which is full of fun things. I'm focusing on the Oh What Fun red perspective title today. So I actually have a photo of my daughter singing Jingle Bells, so that was kind of perfect. And I also have this paper, it's a Cartabella collection, and it has Jingle Bells on it. I bought it for the other side, it was like blue snowflakes. Very pretty, very wintry, as this was kind of perfect for this photo and this story, I figured that I would attempt to use it. Now it's very busy and not kind of really my style, so of course I had to cut it all up and rearrange it entirely before I could actually use it. What I've done is I've taken the section with the music notes on with the song, and I've cut that out using my trimmer. So I've trimmed around it cut that out completely, and I'm going to put it onto a piece of white cardstock. I'm going to distress the edges of that as well, and probably stick it at an angle. I've also cut out the title, Jingle Bells, that was on the top of the piece of paper, so that kind of goes well. I'm going to use that as my title, that works well. I then felt that I wasn't quite sure where to put my photos. Now the background of this layout is very busy, which is not really my style, so I felt like I needed some separation between the photos and the background, and I didn't want to use white because I have a white background in the background. So I found a piece of very pale pink paper, that's from one of the papers in the November hip kit. So I've just cut a piece of that that's slightly bigger than where my photos will go. It also gives me somewhere to put my title too. I've also pulled out some tissue paper. Now this is not real tissue paper. I'm not quite sure what it is, but it's very, very soft, and it tears really easily, and it crumples, gets creased really easily as well. It's not great to work with, so I think I'll throw this away and find some proper tissue paper from somewhere that has more of a waxy feel. This is very, very soft, this one, and every time I put my tape on it, it ripped it. It's very annoying. But anyway, it gave a nice soft feel over the pink, so that worked well. I'm just mounting my two photos onto journaling cards. Now I've cut those from the same collection, the Cartabella collection, and I've cut them from the cut apart sheet there. I've mounted one because I wasn't planning to use that card, and the other one I wanted to use the blue side. So it had like a wintry scene on the back of that paper, so just a section of that worked well as a border. So I've mounted my photos on there, distressed the edges, and then my Oh What Fun is going to sit over the top of that pink piece of paper, or there's a little bit of tissue paper there as well, but mostly pink, and then it shows up really well, whereas it wouldn't have shown up too well against the musical notes paper. So on that musical notes paper initially there were also some baubles or ornaments coming down one side, so I thought I would fussy cut some of those. Now they were on quite a busy background themselves, with red and greenery and all sorts, so actually fussy cutting them was quite tricky, and I've had to cut them really very close, whereas normally I leave myself quite a decent border, they don't quite look right with the strings, I think the problem with the strings was that I couldn't cut them thin enough to not have too much border around the edge. So anyway, I've managed to fussy cut as many as I could, and then I'm just going to kind of arrange them onto the layout, and I've settled on the right hand side there too. So I have another journaling card here from that same collection and that cut apart sheet, and I'm just distressing the edges of that, and I'm going to stick it behind my photo stack as well. Here I go with ripping the tissue paper. It's so annoying. It was really, I can't believe how soft that tissue paper was. I don't even know where it came from. It wasn't in a normal scrapbooking delivery, that's for sure. So just getting my paper, my photo stack sorted now. So I've got my photo stack in place, both mounted, both stuck. Oh What Fun is stuck down to that red perspective. And then I've got my two pieces of journaling card stuck behind as well, just to give it an extra bit of paper layer, really. Extra bit of interest. Jingle Bells title is going above my photos. And then I'm just arranging my ornaments now on the right-hand side. So I'm pretty happy with how that's looking. I think they look a lot better against the white background than they did on the full paper. I would have been able to use that as a full sheet of paper. It would just never have happened. There wasn't enough white on it for me. I'm glad that I managed to cut it all up and use it. You know, it's really great that that I have managed to use something so outside my comfort zone. Just getting my ornaments stuck in place now. I'm raising them up on foam pads. I'm getting a bit hung up on the fact that they should be dangling down from the top, so they should all have strings that come down from the top. So I'm trying not to worry about that, because really these things don't matter. Just adding some chipboard stickers here and there. So I've added Santa over to the right of my photo. I've added some lights there, getting my baubles stuck down there too, getting my title stuck in place. That's the one that's cut from the paper, so that's just a paper layer. And then I've got a little chipboard piece down to the left of Oh What Fun. Well, I don't like that, and that gets moved. And now I'm just trying to arrange some other perspectives onto this layout. So these snowflakes, I can't remember if they're from the November kit or if they are from the store. I know I had a pack from the store, I think. So they're definitely available to buy separately rather than just in a kit, but they may have been in the November kit, I can't quite remember. So I've moved that little piece over to the right now. I've got my three snowflakes in place, so a large blue one, a pale pink, and a white one, or frosted white. And then I found this other journaling card, again from the same collection. It had this really nice tree on it, so I decided to fussy cut that out, and that's going to go to the left of my Oh What Fun instead of that little chipboard piece that I tried to put there earlier. So I'm just building up my kind of cluster, my vertical cluster on the right hand side. You can see there's a definite kind of vertical design going on there now, and I'm going to keep adding to that as things progress, making sure that everything is stuck down. These chipboard pieces, not very sticky, so I'm having to apply glossy accents under each one to make sure they don't fall off at a later date. So this tree was fussy cut from a journaling card, so I'm just getting that stuck in place with foam pads, and then coming back to revisit my chipboard sheet to see if there's anything more that I can put on there. I put a few little snowflakes here and there, and now I'm coming in with some silver twine. So I was still debating whether I should put string on all the baubles and hang them off the top of the layout, but in the end I decided that I could get away with a few twiddles, one to the right of the photos and one to the left of the little Christmas tree there. So just getting those stuck in place, I do have to put string on this one, so I just tucked it under the next bauble, so it still doesn't go all the way up to the top, but I think it's okay. I can live with it. Now I am thinking that the bottom part of this musical paper needs some red pom-pom trim, because lots of things need red pom-pom trim because it's awesome. So I'm just getting that stuck in. I do actually add some silver stitching through it later on as well. I just felt that the vertical design down the right-hand side of the layout needed a bit of extra. It needed a bit of grounding. Not grounding, because that would be on the ground at the bottom of the layout, but at the top it just kind of gave it some more weight. So I've just cut out a little triangle, a tear, added in a piece of the dark blue paper that has the snowflakes all over it, and that just brought in the blue from the baubles as well, and it just looked great. I was really pleased. I was debating whether I should use blue or red paper, but blue won. So I'm now adding in another snowflake to the right of my Jingle Bells title, and I found a couple of little snowballs as well that were in that perspective set too, so I'm just getting those stuck in place as well. So I'm using glossy accents to stick down all my perspectives. I find that that's the best method for me, even though they're frosted, it still looks fine as far as I'm concerned. And then I wanted to add in some sequins too, so it's got a set by Spiegelmum Scraps. I've also there's lots of blues. It's called Southern Bluebells, I think that that set, but they also had some silver in. So this whole layout speaks to me in silver rather than gold, even though there is a small amount of a gold colour. It's not foiled in a couple of the baubles at the top there. But silver was the thread that I used, and silver sequins most definitely. I've also got some red shimmers paint, and also some silver shimmers paint too, so that I can add some splatters along that vertical design on the right hand side. So you can see it's really built up now with all the snowflakes, the snowballs, the splatters, the sequins, and that's me done. So I did actually add a little bit of journaling down at the bottom after I was finished, and that's it. I'm done. Thank you so very much for joining me today. Make sure you check out the December Fox Box, because it's completely awesome. Thank you for watching. That was Niki Rowland for Bramble Fox.